Yeah, Sera and the Royal Stars is honestly just one of the most beautiful books I've ever had the pleasure of working on. It's so much fun to edit. John Sway and Audrey Mock are co-creating. Raul Angulo is doing colors and letters by Jim Campbell of Wasted Space. It's this really like incredible sort of mashup of like just heartwarming, like humorous moments and like heartbreaking sort of family moments. And it's this big epic quest. Sera, the princess of Parsa, has to restore these fallen stars to the heavens so the seasons can turn again, and it will end like this famine that's been sort of plaguing her kingdom and empire. And it's this expansive quest, but it manages to always stay super grounded on these really, really fun, really great characters that you can't help but fall in love with.
Because the pacing is perfect, and it's like laugh out loud funny.
Yeah, there are moments that will just kill you. Like, you'll crack up so much, and then the next page you'll turn and you clutch your chest and like almost cry. And I love that so much. I love whenever somebody can pull that off. I feel like anybody who loved Heathen or like Monstrous or Isola or Avatar: The Last Airbender, those kind of quest stories that do that, that capture like humor and heart, but also have like really felt stakes that are big and impactful, they're going to love Sera and the Royal Stars. So I cannot recommend that book highly enough. And then behind, right next to that, we have Resonant. Resonant is a story that I have been in love with since the first day that David Andrie pitched it to me. And David Andrie is one of these genuinely unsung heroes of comics. He has volunteered at the Skybound booth since day one of Skybound. And he has hand-sold so many thousands of comic books to fans just purely as a volunteer. And he has introduced hundreds of creators to editors that have sparked huge careers, and he's good friends with people that have enjoyed those massive sort of breaks in their careers and those big pushes, and it's all because he's just genuinely one of the best people I've ever met. And he pitched Resonant to me a couple years ago, and we worked on it and we got it in line, and we figured out when we wanted to launch it. We found the perfect co-creator, which was the biggest thing. And Alejandro Aragon is the artist. And that pairing of Alejandro on inks and Jason Wordy on colors is unreal. The book looks so good. And it's this crazy, cool sort of psychological thriller meets like post-apocalyptic Odyssey. And it's about a father who has a chronically ill youngest son, a daughter and another son, and he needs to set out and sort of venture from their secluded home that they've built in the woods to go get medicine for his youngest son who needs it. And you can tell there's something wrong with the world, some catastrophic thing that's happened. And what's revealed by the end of issue one is that these waves sort of sweep across humanity that unlock our deepest impulses. So the worst, most terrifying, awful thoughts that you have, that you're thinking, whatever thing's scaring you most at that moment, or you're most anxious about, you act on. So the worst enemy becomes yourself and whoever's closest to you when these waves hit. And so it's the story of this father trying desperately to get back to his children after he ventures out and these waves start hitting again. And it'll mess you up. It's nerve-wracking. It's a really intense emotional book, but it is also just breathtakingly beautiful and full of some really, really cool action moments too. So yeah, both of those come out in July, and they FOC June 24th.
They both dropped July 17th, just in time for San Diego Comic-Con. So, we'll have them there at the table, but we wanted to make sure that everybody else in the country could have them then too. So, nobody was left behind.
Yeah. So definitely check those out. Those two books are things that we've been working on for a long time, and these creative teams have poured their heart and soul into those books. I know you won't be disappointed. Like, I'm really excited to share some advanced looks at it with you guys, because I think you'll love them.
Now, of course, guys, you guys are going to do vault vintage variants for these releases as well, right? Correct?
Correct.
Yeah. Yeah, we've actually got a couple surprises that are coming that we're really excited about.
You guys might know a little something about one of those surprises. I don't know. But, yeah, we've got some vault vintage stuff coming. And, you know, in previews, everybody's seen two. So for Sera and the Royal Stars, we did, you know, maybe this is a cat that ate the canary moment, but we did an homage to Heathen, Heathen number one. And, you know, it's extraordinary. And again, you know, you just get to see how incredibly versatile Nathan is. And you also get to see how amazing an artist Natasha was in the first place for somebody to imitate her style and still create a piece that's so superb. And then Adrian can tell you about what we did for Resonant.
Yeah, for Resonant, we did Why the Last Man. So classic cover. Who doesn't love BKV? Why the Last Man is one of my all-time favorite series, and it was one of the series that most inspired David to create Resonant in the first place. This kind of epic, global, spanning quest after a sort of catastrophic moment focused in on, you know, this sort of single person trying to find their way through all of this. So like thematically, they're super similar. We did this killer homage cover, the vault vintage of for Resonant of Why the Last Man. It is stellar. I think you'll absolutely love it. And then we've got a couple extra fun things cooking up that I think I'll leave it to you guys to you know, maybe spill the beans at some point.
Yes, yes. We've definitely got some surprises coming along the way, guys. Stay tuned to Simpleman's Comics YouTube channel. You'll see it here first, as always. Remember...